I think we are rolling with our recording. Good morning, everybody. This is LisaBug Mind-Body Blend, where we take a fusion of different mind-body formats and connect them together in a really nice flow to strengthen the core, to stretch, to tone, to build endurance in our muscles. And what we need today is I have a yoga mat and a chair. I'm on carpeting today, a little softer surface. So if you're on hardwood floor, you might also like a little something extra for knee padding later on in class, or a little blanket maybe to cover yourself up with at the end. We'll do a little bit of a restorative pose to finish our practice. So the chair we're going to use for balance and stability as we work with some movements in barre and Pilates that require a little bit of balance. You can also use a wall for that as well. So we'll start with a Tai Chi warm-up. Get some music going for us today. Make sure that you're working within a level that feels good for your body. So we're just going to come with feet just about hips distance apart, maybe a little wider, and let your arms hang nice and heavy. Keep your feet still and begin to rotate your body from side to side. And I just want you to let your arms just slap against your body. So as if you don't have any control over them whatsoever. This is a wonderful shoulder release just to warm up and allow the synovial fluid to enter the shoulder joint. And I just want you to notice your head. And as you're moving from side to side, just let your head follow the movement of your shoulders. Spine is nice and long. And then keep this going with the body, but look right at the screen. So I'm not going to have you move your head whatsoever. So now your upper back is moving independently of your neck. Arms are still heavy, abdominals gently drawn in. And this can be at whatever pace feels good for you. And then keep your body moving as it is, and I want you to turn your head the opposite direction that you're moving your upper body. So as your arms go to the right, you're looking over the left shoulder. This requires a little bit more concentration as we're moving the head in that opposite direction. A wonderful warm-up for the neck. Might feel like you need to go a little slower to be able to do this opposite direction. Couple more each side here. Then keep going with the body and bring your head straight forward. And then just slowly, slowly let your arms come to a stop. Bring your palms forward, close your eyes, and just notice the sensations you're feeling in your body. So we really started to get the blood flow going down the arms, almost into the fingertips. You might feel them tingling. Pull in a nice deep breath in through the nose. And exhale through the mouth. Two more, cleansing breath. Inhale. One more, in through the nose, out through the mouth. Blink your eyes back open. Widen your feet just a little bit more. Turn your toes out a little bit and start to shift your weight to the right side, to the left side. I want you to notice your knees and your ankles and your hips. We'll start to move the arms across and across as we start to build into a cloud hands movement. So as one arm goes across, the other arm scoops underneath, scoops. If you want to get a little fancier, add a big rotation. Start to move the spine. Looking all the way over the left shoulder and the right shoulder. So this essentially is a shoulder roll, but it's not above the head. So for most of us that might have shoulder injuries or past surgeries, this is in a safe zone for movement of the shoulders. If you'd like to go deeper, bring this top arm up. A little soft bend in the elbow. Now feel your body bending sideways. So not as much rotation, but lateral flexion of the spine, stretching through the lats. Just let the breath occur whenever it feels natural for you to breathe. We'll go twice more each direction. And then just come back to center, relax your arms, check in, see how everything's feeling through the body. Then step your feet about hips distance apart. Take your right foot, take a little step forward and bend your knee and push away. Your left foot steps forward, bend your knee, push away. So my feet are parallel. So when I bend that front knee, I feel a little baby stretch in the back ankle and the Achilles tendon in the calf. Now with the arms, bring them forward and down. And this is very floating feeling with the arms. So they feel really light and they lift from the back of the hand. And notice your ankle or your wrists. They flex, and then they flex the opposite direction. So we start to warm up that joint for any exercises we might have on our hands today. Now for safe shoulders, you'll stay low. If you'd like to make this bigger, take it up and down. Bigger range of motion, whatever feels comfortable for you. We're warming up through the knees as we take some pressure into that joint, warming up through the quads, the fronts of the thighs. Now we can begin to get our spine into this action. If you'd like, maybe take a little bit of a back bend and back down. Just notice how that feels in your lower back. Not necessary if you don't want to do that movement, but if you do, keep your abdominals engaged. And then our last option is to add a nice big circle around and step in. And then put a big inhalation into that circle. Breathe in and let it go. Two more on each leg. And you can come right back in here, the smaller movement for the shoulders. One more on each side. And then step back in and check in with your body. If there's any areas giving you warning signals today, make note of that as we progress. Take your legs nice and wide into wide Wu Chi and soften through your knees. We'll take a big circle of the arms around and do a block, pressing into the palms, looking over that left shoulder. And again, circle around and sink. So as I'm circling, I'm coming up out of the squat, straightening the legs, and then sinking down as low as you feel comfortable. You can can make this small or really take it deeply into the knees. For the arms not going over the head, just we're right in here. Still doing the circling action of the shoulders, just a little bit smaller. Knees tracking over the ankles as you sink. Tailbone drops right down to the floor so we're not overly arching the lower back. One more. Inhale. Exhale. Now keeping the palms here, stretch and reach to a nice side bend. Take this palm, press it away from you. Look down. Look up. Look down. Look up. And press yourself back up. Take your block to the right side. Circle around. Inhale. Exhale. Now your vision is such an important part of Tai Chi. So you're looking in the direction that you're blocking. You're warding off anything dangerous, anything that you don't want to enter into your life. So maybe you're going through some anxiety right now. We'll ward that off with our block, spirit, mind, and body. Small shoulder movement, we're right in here. Maybe deeper into those legs. So we've done quite a few squats now, so we should really be feeling the heat building into those thighs. Two more. Big breath in. Exhale. One more. And hold your block. The palms stay, and we take this into a side bend. The left palm presses out. The right palm presses over the head. Look down. Look up. Look down. Look up. And rise. Take a nice big breath in, stretch. Exhale. Two more. One more breath. And exhale. Just rise up. Step your feet back in. And then we'll need a chair today. And you can, depending on how far you want to bend over, you can have either the short end of your chair toward you, or you can turn it around and have the higher end. And facing your chair, we'll take the right foot forward, the left foot back into a Warrior One stance. So in Warrior One, this front knee is bent, the back leg is straight, and the back foot is slightly turned out, just a small angle. And we'll stretch the arms up and come into goalpost arms. So I'm opening through the chest, pulling the shoulder blades back. Now your arms can be down lower here. This is good too as well. We're going to do a small, tiny movement, squeezing the shoulder blades and slightly releasing, maybe about an inch. Squeeze back and release that. So you're using the strength of your upper back to actually create a stretch in the fronts of the shoulders in the pecs. So we're strengthening through the mid-upper back while we're stretching the opposing muscle groups, building good posture. Head is neutral. Squeeze back twice more. Stretch. And one more. Squeeze back. Hold. And we'll start to slowly straighten out the front leg and reach the hands either to the hips here, or you can clasp them behind your back. Maybe if you have a yoga strap at home, that would be a wonderful tool to hold behind you as well. We're going to come into pyramid. So both legs are straight. We start to hinge forward until we feel a stretch down the back of the front leg. Now here's where your chair can also come in nice and handy. We can place the fingertips on the chair for some support and stretch down. Now the spine should be long, not curved and hunched and rounded. So slightly bring your head to neutral, bring your spine to neutral. It should feel like you're lifting your sitting bones behind you just a bit. From here, soften the front knee, give it a little bit of a bend, and lift up into a warrior three, hands on the chair. Step this back just a smidge. So check your pelvis. Sometimes what happens in warrior three, the back hip will lift and rotate up. So I want you to level off your pelvis. Your hips are super level. If you don't need the chair for balance, you can experiment with letting one hand or both hands go. Flexing the back foot, we'll do that small little movement like we did in the chest and shoulders, and we'll squeeze and lift the leg up and come down about an inch or two. Lift up and come down. Now you may begin to notice this standing leg is going to get a lot of work through the hip and the thigh. Make sure this knee isn't locked out. It's a soft straight, or you can bend it a fair amount. Squeeze through that upper leg glute. Tighten. Your leg is as straight as you can get it, sending it out through that heel. Two more repetitions. Lift. One more. Lift and hold. Now notice your pelvis is level to the floor. We're going to begin to turn the pelvis open into our half moon pose. So the pelvis rotates first so that we stack the left hip on top of the right. And then we can bring that left hand to our hip or up to the ceiling. We try to rotate the whole body to that back wall behind us or front wall, wherever direction we're facing. Then if you feel comfortable, lift this top leg up, lower down a couple of inches. Lift and lower. Slow movement, nice straight leg. We're working on that balance, working on strengthening the hips of both the lifted leg and the standing leg. Now for balance, it's easiest if you're looking down towards your chair, but you can rotate your head and gaze up to that top hand if you want to give it a go. Little bit harder for the balance. Two more. Lift up. One more. Now keep your pelvis where it is. Just rotate your hand down. I want you to feel a twist here. So I'm trying to keep my left hip up, up, up while my shoulders are facing the floor. One more breath. Then level off your pelvis, lower your leg, and take a downward dog standing. So you're going to reach your hands out nice and long and stretch here. Soften your knees a little bit, curve your back, standing cat stretch, and begin to roll up. And lengthen the spine to mountain pose. Ooh, how do we feel? You might feel some in that standing hip. Let those sensations slightly dissipate. And when you're ready, step your right foot now back into warrior one. So warrior one doesn't have a really long stride. It's kind of medium. It's not way far back. So we want to get the hips to square forward. Reach the arms up. Open to goalpost. Squeeze through the backs of the shoulder blades. Release about 2 inches. Squeeze again. So you are creating your own tension and your own resistance isometrically. So it's the same action if you were in the weight room at the gym and you had that rowing machine and you pulled back and squeezed the shoulder blades against 40 pounds, but you're creating your own resistance. Feel the stretch in the pecs and the shoulders. Zip up through the core, pull the belly in. One more time, squeeze back and hold. Bring the hands to the hips or maybe behind you into chest expansion. Straighten the front leg. Make sure your pelvis is squared and begin to shift into our pyramid to stretch the front hamstring. The hands can stay here, or we can bring the fingertips to the chair to help guide yourself down just a little deeper. Check your spine. Take any roundness out of your back by tipping your sitting bones slightly up, lengthening the spine through the crown of the head, your neutral spine. Let the breath move in and out through the nose. Now put a little soft bend in the front knee as we start to lift up into your warrior three. So this leg comes up behind you. You're holding onto the chair, either at the high point of your chair or the low. Square off your hips. So I automatically go into this rotation a little bit. So you have to really focus on dropping that lifted leg pelvis so it's level. Flexing the foot, toes are pointing down. Nice straight leg, lift it up, squeeze the butt, and lower it a couple of inches. Lift and lower. So these are slow movements, so you can really focus on tensing that muscle up and retaining that tension for just a little bit. We could certainly do these really fast, but we probably wouldn't experience the same benefit of the muscular contraction. Standing leg is slightly softened, or you can bend it a fair amount. Two more repetitions. Lift and lower. Lift and hold. So this is our warrior three level pelvis. We'll start to rotate the hips to stack the right one on top of the left as we come into our half moon. So this top hand can go to the hip, can reach up to the ceiling. So this really opens up the hip of this standing leg. So when the pelvis was level to the floor, it's a closed hip pose. When we rotate the pelvis to the side, it's an open hip pose. So the outside seam of your pants should be facing the ceiling. We'll lift that leg up and down a couple of inches. Squeeze it up, down. The outer thigh, medial glute, is the prime mover here. So we'll start to feel this, but our stabilizing hip on the floor might be really talking. Zip up through the core. Really straight leg, reach out through that heel. Some of you might be able to let go of the chair. We'll lift it twice more. Up and hold your half moon. So notice your vision really makes a difference, whether you're looking down, whether you're looking neutral, or rotating that head up. Ooh, super challenging here. If you fall out of the pose, start getting wobbly, take your time to come back in. Breathing in and out through the nose. One more breath. Now leave your hips just the way they are and bring this hand down. So I'm turning my shoulders to face the chair, but I'm lifting my right hip up and back. So I'm in a really nice twist. Just a couple breaths. Still firing the outer thigh on that right leg. And then level off your pelvis. And let that foot float to the floor. Take a standing down dog, reaching the hands out long to the top of the chair, a little stretch through your lats. Then bend your knees, curve your back like a cat, tucking the tailbone under. And then begin to roll up one vertebra at a time. Coming back to stand, check in. Then I'm going to turn my chair to where I can hold on to the high end to use it a little bit more for balance. We'll turn the toes out into Pilates position one. Squeeze your inner thighs, lift and lower. If you can let go of that chair, we rise and fall. Now for a little bit more of a challenge, we'll lift and then just lower about an inch. Lift, lower an inch. Imagine a string through the top of the head, really pulling yourself up for good posture. Tighten the glutes, the buttocks, the inner thighs, and zip up through the lower belly. That feeling of when you put on a pair of jeans that may be a little bit too tight, and we zip up, flattening that lower belly. Now lift up on the balls of the feet and hold. Start to do a small demi-plié. So we open the knees and we rise back up. So our goal is to stay on the balls of the feet. This is called high half toe. If that's too much, the heels can drop and you can do your demi-plié right here. Good. So our goal is not to bend over when we do this exercise. We've got the chair so we can go straight down as if our back is going down a wall. Two more. One more. And lower the heels. Good, we'll take a side stretch. And other direction. Back to center. Balancing on the right foot, pick up the left knee. So I still have a turnout, so my knee is open. Lift that leg, extend it, circle it out, and lower it back down. Lift, extend, circle, and lower down. So if you don't need the chair, you can just bring your arms here, maybe in front of you. The arms can also follow the leg. So as the knee lifts, the arms lift, extend, open, and lower down. Now it's almost impossible not to lean over to the side just a little bit when we're doing that circling action, but make it very small. And the leg doesn't have to lift high. We can be right in here. Three more repetitions. Good, notice the muscles you're firing. We have quad and hip flexor, outer thigh and glute. One more rep. And release. Step this leg out, squat, pull in. Squat, pull in, with or without the chair, with or without arms. So we're going into a wide position two, back to position one, heels touching, toes rotated out. Breathe. Four. Three. Two. One. Relax. If you need to switch your chair to the other side, take a moment to do that, or you can turn around. Back to our position one, heels together. Raise up on the balls of the feet and either all the way down or just an inch or two. Lift. So I want you to feel the backs of your lower legs working, your calves, but also move that action up the back of the thighs into the butt and into the inner thighs. So everything is really bracing in that lower body. Up. We've got that string drawing up through the top of the head. Let's bring it up and hold at the top. Keep the spine nice and long as we do our demi-plié and rise up. Goal is to stay in high half toe in the balls of the feet, but I know sometimes we have maybe a bunion or a little bit of arthritis in the toes, so maybe yours needs to be down. And you know, the benefit of having your heels on the ground is a stretch in the ankle and in the Achilles tendon. So there's some benefits there. And we've got two more repetitions. Plie. And rise. Pull the belly in. One more. Hold up, hold up. Drop those heels down. We pick up the right knee. It's in external rotation. Extend it straight, circle it out and around. Bring it up, straighten, circle. So our goal with Pilates and with Barre is to do these actions of the lower extremity without moving the pelvis. So we don't want to scoot over to the side or circle it around. We want to keep it as locked in as possible. Adding the arms. Good. Sometimes it's nicer just to have that chair for a tiny bit of balance, maybe one finger, so that you can really control and you don't have to worry about the balance as much. You can make the movement precise. We'll do three more on this side. Check in with your shoulders. Make sure they're level, not one higher than the other. Two more. Last one. Closing to position one. Step out, squat, bring it together. Arms are just an accessory, so we don't have to lift. We can make it small right in here. The length you step out is entirely up to you. Open, step in. Now think about the pushing away from the floor. So as you connect with the floor, push away. It's where that right quad is working, the glute. Five more. Four. Three, two, last one, relax. Good, remove your chair. And then we'll come back into our wide Wuchi position, toes turned out. Soften those knees, bend them as deeply as you'd like. Bring your fingertips right in front of your shoulders or just to the side, and we'll tip, dropping this elbow towards the thigh, and then tip the other direction. So this is lateral flexion of the spine. The legs are just holding that squat. Now as you tip to the right, reach the hand down, and hand down. See how far you can comfortably go. This is working a big muscle in the back, the QL, quadratus lumborum, our oblique muscles. If you want more stretch as you reach the hand down, other arm goes over. The legs start getting tired. You can come up out of the legs and just continue to do this with the straight thighs. Two more on each arm. Really build in heat. Or maybe it's the fireplace. I think it's both. Now, hands here. Straighten the legs. Reach both arms up and then sink down. So this is moonflowers. And as you sink down, pull your elbows back and down. Squeeze the back of your shoulder blades, that lower tip, right together. Inhale. Exhale. Again, we're strengthening through that upper back to bring the chest into good posture and the shoulders. If it bothers you to reach over the head, we'll just stay right in here. Three more. And two. One more. And straighten the legs up. Bring fists to your sacrum, one on either side. Pull your shoulder blades back. Slightly press your hips forward. Lengthen the front of the spine into standing camel. So it's up to you how far you tip back here. You stay in a range that feels okay for your body. Two more breaths. One more. And come up. You can do standing camel once again, or we'll come down to the knees right here in place for a kneeling camel. Your toes can be tucked under behind you or your feet flat. Take those fists. Press in. Pull the shoulder blades back. Lengthen. Slightly squeezing the buttocks. And when you tighten the buttocks, you'll notice you feel this release in the fronts of the hips. It's our kneeling camel pose. Now, your throat is lengthened, but you don't want to tip your head back so far that you can't swallow. So that is a good test to see if your head is back too much. Lengthen, and then wet your lips, take a swallow. If you couldn't swallow, then your head is back too far. Lift your chin forward a bit more. One more breath. And come up. So if you're still standing, go ahead and come down into your knees, and we're going to do Pilates thigh stretch. So with this one, I like my toes tucked under, but if you have problems with your toes and arthritis, you can keep your feet flat. We'll reach the arms out ahead, and the body shifts back, and we come up. So the problem with this exercise is it's really intense in the quads, so sometimes our body defaults to doing this and setting our butt back. So I want you to keep this joint level and just hinge back. You're going to feel two things, the quadriceps stretching and the quadriceps working. And just explore how far back you can go. Opening up through the fronts of the hips. Three more. Two more. One more. Lengthen back. And bring it up. Arms reach. Turn to the right side. Lean back a little bit and reach toward your heel or your ankle. Come back up. Turn left. Lean back. Reach to the ankle. So we're doing the same exact movement in the lower body, but we're adding rotation for the core. One more each side. Reach up. And then hands come down to child's pose, the hips shift back, the palms come down to the mat in front of you. Relax your forehead. So that was a nice amount of quad work. So we'll move into the hamstring, coming into bridge pose. So take your time to lower down onto your back. And to engage our hamstrings, what we're going to do here is we're going to do an action that involves digging your heel down in the floor and trying to pull it back towards you. But it's stationary on the floor, so you can't actually move your foot. But the movement is going to create, the action of that movement is going to create a tightening in the backs of the legs. So I want you to lift your toes up, up, up. Your heels are down. And then tuck your pelvis, lift up into bridge. Now this doesn't have to be high. It can just be a small bridge. And then I want you to imagine you're pulling your heels back towards your butt. Try to pull them back and then release them. Pull them back, feel this muscle tightening in the back of the upper leg and release it. Now pull back, hold this tightening here and lift the hips up. Drop about an inch or two. Pelvis is level. Lift, drop an inch or two. Keep those toes up. You'll feel some movement or some tensing in your shins with the toes lifted. Keep pulling your heels back to your butt. Lift up, lower an inch or two. Two more. And one more, lift and hold. Then slowly start to roll down, tucking your pelvis under, stretching through that low back. Now bring your heels and your knees tight together. If they're slightly separated, that's okay too. Now your choice is to do two more sets of what we just did, or one set on each leg. So we'll lift the toes up, push into the heels, come up into a bridge any amount, pulling your heels back towards your butt, lift one foot off the floor, and point your toe, sending that leg right up to the ceiling. We'll lift the hips up and about an inch or two down. And lift. So if this is too much and you're feeling maybe a hamstring cramp, then you can go back down to both heels. If you're feeling your foot or your toes cramping, flex this top foot instead of pointing it. Five. Four. Three. Two. Up and hold. Now, if you need to lower your hips, please do so. We're just going to lower this leg and lift it up five times. Four. Three. Two. And one. Set that heel down. Roll down one vertebra at a time. Then briefly hug your knees into your chest. Little stretch for your low back. Then flex those feet. Bring your heels back down to the mat. lift up into a bridge. Now either keeping both heels down one more time or take the other leg up, toe point or heel flex, lift up into that bridge, lower down an inch or two. Up, down. Small movement, very intense. Squeeze at the top, keep pulling your heel into the butt. Five more, up. Four. Great work for the hamstrings and the glutes. Two more. Up and hold. Now you can either stay up in bridge or set your hips down, and we'll lower this leg and lift it up. Five. It's a big range of motion. Four. You'll feel a little stretch in that leg at the top in your hamstring. Three. Two. And one. Both heels down. Roll down one vertebra at a time. Hug the knees right into the chest. Make some circles around. So to stretch those hamstrings a little bit and work the core, we'll come into scissors. Pilates scissors. We'll start with the right leg up, the left leg long, hold behind the thigh. Your head and shoulders can stay down, or you can curve your spine and do a little bit of a sit up, pulling that leg towards you. And we'll go exhale, exhale, inhale. Exhale, exhale, inhale. In a Pilates, usually the out breath is through the mouth, pursed lips like you're blowing through a straw. So feel the stretch in the hamstrings. Toes can be pointed, or if you're feeling a foot cramp coming on, flex your ankles. Two more each side. One more, holding the left, laying the head and shoulders back down, and bring those knees back into the chest. Bicycle, fingertips are next to the temple. We'll curl up, rotate elbow to knee, then extend the legs. Come back in and rotate to the other side. Extend arms and legs. Rotate. Reach. Rotate. Reach. Now you can take the reach out and just rotate, hold. Rotate, hold. Two more on each side. Obliques. One more each. Come center, both knees in. Roll back. Circle those knees. A couple times each direction. And then bring your knees to tabletop. Hands are by your side with your palms up, so you're not going to use your arms very much. We'll tip the knees to the right. Lengthen the legs. Rebend them. Come to the left. Lengthen. And bend. Your shoulders should stay right down on the mat the entire time. If you're feeling any tension in your lower back, you can take the lengthening out of this exercise and just move the knees from side to side, working through those obliques. Now, continuing as you are, or we'll add a level with this. Tip the knees to one side. Lengthen the legs. Circle them down. Pull the knees back in. Tip them to the other side. Lengthen. Circle down. Bring your knees in. Tip. Lengthen. Circle. Knees in. So a lot of levels here for you to choose from. Really bracing through the core. Shoulders are planted into the mat. We have one more on each side. And relax your feet down to the mat. Let your knees open into a baddha konasana or butterfly pose. And just let the hip flexors relax. And I want you to imagine there's a sponge right between your feet and it's full of water. So squeeze out the sponge by pressing in and then release that tension. Press between your feet and release. Exhale, squeeze the sponge. Release. Now squeeze and hold. Keep the feet pressing each other and lift your buttocks up off the floor, maybe an inch. Lower down. Keep squeezing the feet. Lift and lower. Tightening through the outer thighs, stretching the inner thighs. Lift and lower. Now lift up, hold. So we have the legs pushing in. We have the hips up. Then try to open your legs wider and close in about an inch. Opening the butterfly wings, close in. Keep pressing in with the feet. Keep the glutes lifted off the floor. Open and close. Two more, open. Close, one more, and then relax the hips and close the knees back together. Take a happy baby stretch. So we'll bring the knees up, flex the feet up towards the ceiling. So knees are bent about 90 degrees. We reach for one foot and then the other and pull the knees right down into the armpits, flattening the low back. Take a few deep breaths in. And then we'll come into fish pose. So we elongate the legs down onto the mat. Fish pose is sometimes a little difficult one to get into. So what we do is we take the palms of the hands down onto the floor. And we're just going to lift the head up a little bit. Actually, let's put the hands under the hips. That's kind of nicer to get into. So hands are under the hips. We lift our head up, come up onto the elbows and squeeze them close to each other. And then take your head and extend it back. Now, if you have a block at home, it's a really nice thing to put the block between your shoulder blades so that your upper back is lifted and supported. Now, I want you to make sure you can swallow as we did before. So wet your lips and swallow. If you can't swallow, your head is back too far and you can pull your chin forward. Now, if this is uncomfortable for you, just lay your head down naturally and pick a goalpost arms instead, and just open through the heart. So we're gonna hold here 5 breaths, whichever pose feels best for us today.
Fish pose is wonderful for your thyroid gland. Four more breaths. On that fifth exhalation, slightly lift your chin, lower your chest back down to the mat. You can bend your knees to slide the hands out from underneath the hips. Stretch the arms above the head. So our little restorative pose, if you'd like to cover yourself up with a blanket, you can as well. With the arms up, we'll take the right foot, cross it over the left ankle. And then drop that right foot over to the side until it touches the floor. Now, if arms above your head is uncomfortable, maybe just lace your hands and fold them right across the chest or the abdomen. So this is just a gentle rotation for the hip here. It's a twisting forward fold, figure four stretch, or twisting reclining pigeon. Relaxing and breathing. Let your legs feel heavy. Now, if this figure four position is not comfortable for you, you can take the top leg and just stack it over your bottom leg. And hold this easy twist. Let your mind begin to calm. Bring your awareness to your body and how you feel after your practice today. Maybe stronger, a little less tension and stress and anxiety. Happy with yourself for a job well done. We'll take a preparation breath to begin to move. Inhale. As you exhale, pull those knees back up. Uncross the ankle. Cross the left over the right. Arms can be reaching above the head. And we'll drop the knees over until that foot contacts the floor. If you need to place it on top of a pillow or a block. If your arms are hanging off the floor, they feel uncomfortable, bring them to a comfortable place. Across the abdomen, next to your sides. Your head is just neutral. Relax through your eyelids, your eyebrows, your cheeks and your jaw, your neck muscles. Your shoulders, your upper back and chest, your mid back and rib cage, lower back and belly, hips, right and left sides. Upper legs, the thighs, quads and hamstrings. Lower legs, shins and calves. Your arms and hands and your feet. Take a preparatory breath, inhale. Exhale, pull those knees back to center. Uncross. pull both knees up to your chest. If you feel more comfortable rolling over onto your side to sit up, I want you to do that. Or we're going to do a little rolling like a ball action. So start to round, get some momentum. Might take you 3 or 4 tries. Eventually, coming all the way up to seated. Find a comfortable cross-leg pose. Lengthen your spine. Hands on your knees for grounding today. Lengthen through the crown of the head. A little half circle with the neck. Tipping the head to the right, rolling it down through the center and over to the left. Pausing there. Rolling down back to the right side.